In the name Yahweh is our power to tread on our enemies. We want to give all the honor, glory, and praise to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rabbah Ha, Kodash, the Master, the Elders, a great millstone, sing unto the elect, peace and blessing to the one third. The God of the heaven and earth has given us his name, his only begotten son's name, Yahweh Shai. Yahweh is in the name, Yahweh Shai, Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. And through that name, it's almost the only way we're going to be able to prevail. Yahweh Shai said it, ask anything in my name, and I will give it to thee. And his name is the Heavenly Father's name. And all throughout the Bible, you know, you'll see how the Lord's name resonated with the prophets. And the Lord always answered. One of my favorite examples is the major prophet Elijah. Elijah went against the 400 worshipers of Baal. Salakia. 1 Kings, the 18th chapter, read it. And pretty much, Elijah told the worshipers of Baal, call unto your God to bring down fire and brimstone from the heaven. And they were whipping themselves and cutting themselves and praying and wailing. And Elijah made a mockery of them and said, maybe he's sleep, maybe he's peradventure. But then he laid down the 12 stones with the sacrifice and he called on the name Yahweh. And fire and brimstone licked up the sacrifice. That's what it says, something like that to that extent in the chapter. And after the name of the Lord prevailed over Baal, Elijah, yes, the prophet, took the 400 worshipers of Baal down to the river and slayed them. And I believe this is when Jezebel and some of her contemporaries said, we will not eat until we slay him. And then this is when Elijah ran into the woods. He was crying to the Lord, saying, I'm not better than my father. Let that sink in. Elijah, the major prophet, who was John the Baptist in reincarnation, said, I am no greater than my father's. He was running. So imagine what kind of faith and power we're going to need in these days. And those men will far more integral. I can say that word. Far more integral than what we are today. But nonetheless, those same men are here again today. But the point of the matter is, it was that name. It was that name. When the Lord told Moses to go to his people and let them know that the Lord was going to come save them, the first thing he said was, well, when I go to them, what should I say your name is? Roughly paraphrasing. Yahweh. There's power in that. There's so much power in the name that when you go to, what is it, Acts the 5th chapter, what they say, did we not straightly tell you not to preach in his name? Because you bring much anguish and tribulation to us. Matter of fact, I don't want to butcher that one. Let me just get it. This is Acts chapter 5, verse 25. Then came one of them. I'm sorry. Then came one and told them, saying, behold, the man whom ye put in prison are standing in the temple and teaching the people. Then went the captain with the officers and brought them without violence, for they feared the people, lest they should have been stoned. And then they have brought them. They set them before the council, and the high priest asked them. So you got the wicked scribes and Pharisees. Not every scribe and Pharisee is wicked. All right. Because Paul was a Pharisee of the Pharisees, so stop it. Whose name was Saul before he got converted? Verse 28, saying, did not we straitly, S-T-R-A-I-T-L-Y, so they were like, on him, command you that ye should not teach in this name? And behold, ye have filled Jerusalem with your doctrine and intend to bring this man's blood upon us. That's exactly what it said, all right? And Peter goes on to say, then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, be out to obey God rather than man. So the name has power. The name has so much power. Esau, I tell you, oh, you can call him Jehovah. You can call him Yahweh. You can call him Yahuwah. You can call him Adonijah, right? They tell you all these names, right? Because they know there's power in their name. Why you think out of all the captivities we were in, the only time we lost our heritage or forgot who we were when we was in the captivity of the Greco-Romans, who are also known biblically as the Edomites. And I'm going to tell you why. This is Malachi chapter 1, verse 14. But cursed be the deceiver, which hath in his flock a male, and voweth and sacrificeth unto the Lord a corrupt thing. For I am a great king, saith Yahweh of hosts, and my name is dreadful among the heathen. Let this sink deep inside your soul. The name of Yahweh B'Hashem Yahushua strikes fear in the heathen. You got to remember, I did my sacrifice, I went out and my sacrifice was pretty much was about how these demons and evil spirits know us because Yahusha is with us. So those names strikes fear inside of them. I used to watch GMS Archives 2 all the time. Real heavy. I got to get back on it. Sit down videos elders did inside the apartment, like spoon feeding us. And I remember they were saying how they did exorcisms in that name. And they exorcised people. They've done things, man. And those are some very spiritual men, you know. But that's besides the point. But that name has so much power. And I witnessed it for myself. I'm not going to be calling on the name and it does not have power, because the word God means power. Man, how about Shema Shah has been there for me? The Lord has saved me. Like, it's been times in my life, I'm thinking like, it's a reason why I didn't die that day, because you wanted me to be here today. And that's only through the spirit and power, how about Shema Shah, right? So we have power in that. And Yahweh is our power, and it's to tread down our enemies. So this is Psalms 118, verse 1 through 2. And verse 7 through 11. O give thanks unto Yahweh, for he is good, because his mercy endureth forever. How so? Because the Lord has enlightened us with the Ruach HaKodesh, that 144,000 and the 1/3 shall pass through the fire. Meaning, we shall be changed in the twinkling of an eye and get new bodies, but we have to endure unto the end. Therefore, the only way we can endure to the end is if the Lord mercy endureth with us unto the end. Now that's heavy. Let Israel now say that his mercy endure forever. Indeed, Yahweh taketh my part with them that help me. Therefore shall I see my desire upon them that hate me. Remember, they hate him that rebuketh and negate. They hate us for rebuking them and negate. And it speaketh uprightly. What's that, Amos 5 and 10? Or Amos 5 and 14 and 15? Right? Verse 8. It is better to trust in Yahweh than to put confidence in man. Right? It is better to trust in Yahweh than to put confidence in princes. All nations compass me about, but in the name of Yahweh will I destroy them. And how do they compass us about when we're out there in the highways and byways? Hell, even in everyday life. Because this is Babylon. All nations are here. You know, whether they smile in your face or not, they always had those thoughts in their mind like, you people were in slavery. Right? But remember what Paul said, if at all possible, be at peace with all men. Verse 11, they can pass me about. Yea, they can pass me about, but in the name of Yahweh, I will destroy them. So, where's the sleeper cells? Listen, it's some, you know, cool Edomites, you want to say, or whatever, people like that, that where I work at. But man, when the Lord gave us some new bodies, I ain't gonna remember none of that shit. Pardon my language. All that, hey, how you doing? Nope, none of that. None of that. I may preserve you to be a slave, a servant, a serf, a peasant, but you're still a heathen, right? And 2/3 you heathens too. Yeah? I close our precept. Zechariah 12, verse 8 through 9. In that day shall Yahweh defend the inhabitants of Jerusalem. It ain't talking about all of Israel. It's talking about only the 1/3 in 144,000. The Israel of God. Galatians 6 and 16. Go read that. And he that is feeble, and he that is feeble among them, at their day shall be as David. Didn't David run through a troop? Said Saul has killed his thousands, but David's his tens of thousands. David said, by my Lord, I have run through a troop. Do you know what it means to run through a troop? A troop. You're talking about soldiers who train all their life. He ran through a troop. The Lord making his feet like hind's feet. You know what hind is? It's like a deer. Anything can run about 40 miles an hour. Or a gazelle. The Lord, he even said, because of the Lord, he was able to leap or bound over a wall. We ain't talking about some little 5-foot wall in the alley in the hood behind a convenience store. We're talking about walls that enter into castles. I want to say castles, to like kingdoms, villages, you know what I mean? Yes, garrisons, all of that. By the Lord. He even said by the name of the Lord, the strength of the Lord, he was able to bend a bow of steel. Think about Superman, the old Superman cartoons. Then they say in a single bound, he did what? Leaped over a building. Was he able to bend what? Steel with his hand? Was he able to run what? Really fast? So who the hell you think Superman is? Shalawan, the brother of what? The brother love that Superman emoji. And it's facts. That's us. I like to say Mr. Manhattan because he can manipulate the elements and everything. But hey, we all the Marvel characters because we're just marvelous. We're a marvelous nation. Oof. How about that? Let's get back. I got to read it again. Zechariah 12 and 8 through 9, I'm close out. In that day shall Yahweh defend the inhabitants of Jerusalem. And he that is feeble among them at that day shall be as David. And the house of David shall be as God, as the angel of Yahweh before them. That's heavy. But once again, it's the name. And the name Yahweh is our power to tread on our enemies. Verse 9, I'm going to close out. Zechariah 12 and 9. And it shall come to pass in that day that I will seek to destroy all the nations that come against Jerusalem. Like it says in Acts, the 4th chapter, there was no other name under heaven where a man might be saved. That wasn't plural. It didn't say names. It said name. And Yahweh is in the name Yahweh Shai. So with that being said, pray you was edified and fed. Stay in spirit, no fear, just endure it. Ask for forgiveness. Pray without ceasing. Stay humble. Remain diligent. Go, mashallah. Go flop a ball. Shalom.